I'm Clark Patterson, head of product marketing over here at StreamSense. Kiran Basu is our head of product management. And then Brian Duxbury, as you see here, our chief technologist. Our core platform is open source. So we take a lot of pride in the fact that we've got a north of 95% customer retention rate. We're kind of a hybrid open source company, if you will. So we do have just a support model for our open source. But then we also have a lot of proprietary capabilities that folks can only get through a subscription. In the last fiscal year, 5x revenue growth on an annualized basis. So a lot of interest in capabilities that we're bringing to market. We do take a lot of pride in the recognition that we get. Cool Vendor last year, the Datanami Editor's Choice Award recently for best open source product. People are finding and using our product on their own, and they're seeing great value in it, and they're willing to stand up and sing its praises. There's three categories, I guess, that customers recognize us for. The first is just their ability to scale data movement across very complex architectures. Basically remove the barrier of getting data where it needs to be so that you can get onto better things like analytics. A lot of folks really like the ease of use of our platform. There's a lot of ingest components that exist in big data platforms, be it Hadoop, be it Kafka, whatever the case may be, and many people choose to use those things. But oftentimes you want just kind of an easy button of sorts. So our ability to rapidly build and prototype data flow pipelines, do it in a manner that they are insulated from change, and also be able to deploy them in a continuous integration, continuous deployment manner, means that those types of requests, they're dramatically reduced, right? So the net benefit is data is being delivered to the key stakeholders a whole lot faster so that they can do what they're trying to do. Our focus organizationally is around the operationalization of data movement. And we see the way to do that as bringing DevOps types of principles to the problem of data integration. If you kind of fast forward to today, you have those systems, but a whole bunch of new ones for things like artificial intelligence and machine learning that are enabled by data lakes and various other things. So we move into this world of analytics that happens a whole lot faster with a very diverse set of individuals hosted across like a very complicated and complex architecture. You're not taking a different approach to how all these things are woven together and how data is moved around the organization, you could very easily find yourself spending more time in just updating the architecture than actually reaping value from it. And so that's where we see this idea of data ops bringing DevOps types of principles into the mix as a solution. And that's the core tenet to our platform. So the idea of being able to stitch things together in a rigid manner is really thrown out the window, right? We need to find ways to decouple source and destination so that as change occurs, things don't fall apart. They can continue to move as much as possible. And this is a real core component of what we do in our platform. Visibility and monitoring is a big thing. So we really do bring a lot of application performance monitoring type of principles into the data integration space and give you the ability to look at what's happening at any stage of the pipeline. And we see ourselves as a bellwether for data ops, for data integration specifically, and bringing that problem set forward.
Data ops is still the same principles, right? It's automation, collaboration, monitoring. But rather than talking about what the outcomes we want are, we want to talk about what we deliver. The iPhone of data integration, of data pipelines for us, is that same capability, but layered in with sensors and intelligence, which we kind of call an intelligent pipeline. And this is not just data integration anymore. This is the foundations of data ops, right? With technology like this, with theories like this, you can do something bigger and better. We have automated some of the most unfun parts of building a data pipeline, which is deploying it. The ability to compare versions between pipelines at a semantic level is invaluable. In our infrastructure, the pipeline itself is an artifact that does evolve, and you can change it as need be. And that lineage is important to you, both for iterative reasons, but also for like compliance reasons. We really have like what we call like two planes. One is the data plane and one is the control plane. The data plane is where pipelines are running. And then the control plane is segmented away from that. So no actual data, pipeline data will ever flow through Control Hub or DPM. It's all anonymized metrics and configuration stuff.
Rigid batch integration for the purpose of dealing with structured data is a different problem than continuously moving unstructured, semi-structured, structured data across big data platforms. It's just a harder problem to solve, and you need that level of insight, right? So depending on the workloads, our customers see a traditional ETL tool is not solving the problem. so they use us.